Good afternoon. I'm Cameron Clark, and I'm the director of the Indiana Department of Natural Resources. With me today is Dwayne McCoy. He's one of our foresters with our Division of Forestry. But Dwayne's title is much longer. Actually, he's a timber buyer licensing forester. Dwayne, tell us what that is.
In Indiana, we have a law called the Timber Buyer's Law. In that law, anybody who's going to negotiate for timber in the state of Indiana has to have a license or an agent card. And then in order to have that license or agent card, they have to have a bond with the state. So that way, if there is a trespass or a timber theft or non-payment, a landowner can file for what's called an administrative hearing for recuperation of that money. If the timber buyer does not pay it, then it comes from their bond, and then we give that bond to the landowner, and that limits the person's ability to have a license.
Great. And so how does that translate to harvests that occur on state property?
On state property, just like any other landowner in the state of Indiana, we have to have make sure that there is a license or an agent card on any person who's negotiating for timber when we're selling.
And so Indiana does this, other states do too?
Most states do not have a timber buyer's law. Some of them have trespass rules. The only other state that I know of that has a timber buyer's law anywhere like ours, anything like ours, would be Illinois.
And you have another title. What is that?
I am the Best Management Practices Forester, or BMP Forester for short.
What does a BMP Forester do?
I run our Best Management Practices program, which was originally comes from the Clean Water Act. It is to protect water and soil quality, and it's to minimize our impacts as we are logging in the woods.
And so on a particular harvest, what type of activities would a BMP forester engage in?
I train all of our foresters to make sure they know the BMPs and they can work with the foresters on the sites so that as they're having the timber harvest, they can minimize their impacts, and then when they're done with the harvest or an area, then they can close the trail out. Say they went to move a tree such as this, they would have to cut it down, top it, and then pull it up the hill to a main trail. There, when they're done, this soil would be impacted a little bit, so they might have to do things like put in some water diversions and things like that, so any water that's running down the hill over the land does not make it all the way down to the creek.
Great. And so we have BMP foresters at every active harvest site?
All of our foresters on any of our sites are trained for BMPs and to carry them out.
Right. And so those who harvest on our grounds are used to our BMPs, and is it working?
Yes, sir. Actually, we've had our BMPs as a contractual obligation on state forest properties since July 1st of 1999, and they've been enforced that way.
Great. Thank you for your time, Dwayne.
Yes, sir. Thank you.